Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Getting Junk Done. Today's junk, we're working on a 92 F-150. I got the turn signals and the wipers and as well as the headlights are acting a little weird. Now the only thing that I could find that they have in common, after I checked all the fuses and things like that, is the actual switch on the left-hand side of the steering column. So we're going to try and replace all the entire switch. And hopefully that helps at least one of those problems. Now, I know I need to replace the switch no matter what because my wipers won't park correctly. And according to my research, it's the switch itself that kind of goes bad on these trucks. So this is a 92 to 96 F-150 and Ford Bronco. And this will probably be the same for the 97 F-250s and 350s. But don't quote me on that. Now, the part that I got was actually right at the local Advanced Auto Store, and it was I think, $63 after online discounts and all that. I got that and a new washer fluid motor for less than $50, okay? So, did okay that way. All right, I'm going to show you the new part, and then I'll show you the how to take out the old one and put the new one in. All right, so here's the new part. This is the box it came in, and the part itself is right here. So you got the item number on there, and you can see that this is what is going to be in the steering column. All the connections are in there, okay? And it even comes with a new hazard light button, all right? So it's going to be on the steering column like this. You got the actual switch of controls goes up in there, and here is the old one. The old one's right there, okay? So you can see that does that. You got the hazard light up there, the button for that. So what we're gonna have to take off here is there's a bottom cover down here, a couple of screws, okay? And if you watch my cylinder lock video, this will show you how to take that cover off and remove this cylinder lock, okay? So I got another video on just that. But also not only that cover, you gotta take the tilt control off, and this just screws out like that. So I'll take that out now. So what we're going to do is take out those couple of screws, see if that cover comes out pretty easily, and we'll go from there. And I'll show you what it looks like after that. All right, so we got the bottom cover off. And again, I'll put a link to that other video that I did for just the cylinder lock. But this is what it looks like underneath. I hope I'm holding the camera right. Now, what I need to do next is get this top cover off. Now, I'm hoping that this is all I need to do. So as you can see, you got the hazard light there. It's supposed to go through a hole here, okay, on that top cover. And you got all the inside of that column's exposed there. So I gotta get this guy out of here altogether. And I'm hoping it's just a couple of screws and some electrical connections. So let me do some exploring, see if I can get this out of here, and I'll let you know what happened. Okay, so I did some exploring, and it turns out there was only two screws there. You see one up there, okay, and there was another one. Let's see if I can get it on camera. Another one down there, okay. So, is that it? Well, yeah, I think that's the one. It's hard to tell from where I'm holding the camera and all, but it's only two T20 screws. You take those two out, and then the whole thing starts to wiggle. So it looks like now I got to do some finagling here with this cover, get this out of the way, and be able to pull this out so I can disconnect all the electrics. All right, give me a minute and I'll show you what's happening. All right, that wasn't so bad. So I was able to get that cover the top cover to cooperate. Pulled this guy out, just jimmied him a little bit. Now I'm going to pull these electrics off that you see here, these guys, and put them on the new one, and then slide the new one back in and see how easy that goes. I get a feeling that the cover is going to argue a little bit trying to get the new one in. We'll see what happens. Okay, got the new one in, and it was actually not all that bad. There's only two electrical connectors on the back. It's kind of hard to see in the video here, but it's only two. Okay, see, one and two. So, and they're differently shaped, so there's no way to put this on wrong. So if you're worried about, you know, what wire goes where, stop. Just take this off, put the new one on, and you should be good. All right, I'm gonna jimmy this thing up in there in the old spot and see what I can come up with. Okay, got the top cover back on. All I got to do is put the bottom cover back on, put the tilt steering wheel rod back in, and give it a test. Well, I did give it a quick test. The turn signals work, the hazards work, the wiper blades are now parking better, but I have to adjust where the arms are on the actual windshield wiper. I forget what they're called, but right there on the other side of the windshield, okay, where the rod, the geared end comes out of the hood there, I gotta take them off and put the arms back on where they'll park a little better. But right now they are parking consistently in the same spot instead of in different spots over and over. Now my headlights don't work yet, but that's a whole other story probably. So we'll figure this out. But this is gonna be the cleanest part in the truck for a while until I get that all dirtied up. Well, all I gotta do then is put the lower cover on, like I said. All together, I used a Phillips, a T-Tunny 20 Torx driver, and a little tiny flathead to get those electrical connectors off. Well, this was actually a pretty quick job. All right, guys, well, that's pretty much it. That's all you gotta do. Take the two covers off, pull the old one out, put the new one in. It's really a pretty straightforward thing to do. So about 5 minutes is all it took. So anyway, I'd like to thank my new subscribers and viewers for checking out my channel. I really appreciate you guys taking a look at that. It really seems to be growing pretty quickly, at least on my end anyway. But you guys can also find me on Twitter at Getting Junk Done. And if you like the video, please click like, subscribe to the channel, and share the video. Thanks for watching.